How long should I keep my backups? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Let's dive right into the question. Whenever I backup my computer, how long should I keep my backups? I have some from years ago and I want to delete them. It depends. My most common answer for so many different scenarios. There really is no single answer to this question. It really depends on why you're creating the backups and even your own data hygiene, for lack of a better term. And if you're running a business, well, then there are probably other considerations as well. Data retention is the formal term, but there are different situations and they call for different policies. I'll review some of the things that I think are important and give you kind of sort of a bottom line if you're doing nothing else. Okay, when in doubt, if you don't want to put a lot of thought into this, if you're just tired of the rest of the video, here's what you do. You perform monthly full image backups of your entire machine. You perform daily incremental images building on those full image backups. And you keep your backups for 3 months. Anything older than 3 months, delete it. That's actually a pretty good scenario. And without knowing more about your specific situation, it generally covers the common uses of backups, immediate problems and then longer term problems, where we get to define how long longer term is. Think of each backup as a representation of your entire computer at the moment you took the backup. As a result, yesterday's backup is your machine and everything that was on it yesterday. The backup from the day before, well, your machine as it was 2 days ago. The day before that, well, your machine as it was on 3 days ago, and so on and so on. Let's take a look at some of what that implies. Malware. Let's say that your machine gets infected with malware of some sort. As I've stated so many different times, restoring to the most recent backup image from before the malware arrived, in other words, just before the malware arrived, it's the easiest and the only way to honestly prove that the malware isn't still there. By restoring that machine to the image immediately prior to the malware's arrival, the malware just isn't there. So, how far back would we need to go? Well, most malware makes itself known pretty quickly, which is why those first few days, I'll say 3 or 4 days worth of backups, are pretty important. Yes, there's definitely malware that hides for a while longer, sometimes a month, sometimes even longer. Eradicating that kind of malware has other implications, but especially if it's a short-term thing, you suddenly realize that, yep, I've got malware right now, then having that backup from yesterday is like 95% of the time all you need. You just restore your machine to what it had yesterday, and the malware that you got today is gone. The other scenario, or another scenario, is accidental deletion. This happens to us all. Accidents happen to us all. We've all been there. I know I have. The scenario is something like this. You've been working on a file, you're done with it, and you decide you no longer need it, so you delete it. A couple of days later, you basically have that whoops moment and realize that you really didn't mean to delete the file. You really want it back. It's not in your recycle bin. It's long gone from everything else. You haven't done anything else to have an additional copy of that file somewhere. It's gone, except if you've been backing up. You can then go back 2, 3, 4 days to whatever day it was before you deleted the file and recover that specific file, whatever file that might be, from the image backup of your computer. You've been saved again. That's another one. It's a short-term kind of thing. Within the last week or so is usually the window where these kinds of things happen. File corruption is another scenario that comes up relatively frequently. This one's a little bit tougher. Some types of file corruption, and it can be due to malware, but it can also be due to bugs. It can be due to hardware failure. It can be due to any number of different things that aren't necessarily malicious. They're just things that happen. All of a sudden, the file you thought had your Word document in it doesn't, right? It won't open anymore. Well, if you don't have other copies of it scrolled away somewhere else, your backups are the place to go back to. Now, a lot of file corruption happens immediately. That's pretty serious. It's going to hit your operating system. The system itself will fail, and you can then restore, replace the hard disk, do whatever to fix the underlying problem, and then restore from a more recent backup. But sometimes you don't realize that the file has been corrupted, if you will, for days or weeks or sometimes even months. That's where we start opening up this window of opportunity. That's where we start saying, okay, how far back is it likely we might need to do something? Depending on your situation, you may never work on anything that critical, so a couple of weeks is plenty. On the other hand, if what you do is you're living at your computer, but you actually don't access all of your documents every week, maybe you do leave things around for a month or two, then maybe having 3 months worth of backups to be able to go back into is a kind of window that you want to be able to have available to you when something goes wrong. So malware, deletion, corruption, these are all the kinds of things that backups can protect us from. And how quickly they become apparent is the driving factor, in my opinion, for exactly how long you want to keep your backups. Most of the time, it's within a few days. So doing backups at all, keeping a few days worth, absolutely critical. But beyond that, then you need to start setting a window for how long should I expect to be able to go back to? When might I need to, instead of going back to a backup, just start over, for example? I can't answer that question. That's a question for you. I do want to touch briefly on three types of backups that I think the average user really needs to at least have in mind. The first is what I call the safety net. This is where immediately prior to working on a document, you copy that document somewhere else. So there's that other copy over there that you can easily and quickly get back to should you screw something up in the original or the one you're working on. And that's actually not what I've been talking about. That's a manual step that you would actually do to protect yourself before you take some kind of risky action, where editing a document can be a risky action. Another good example is taking an additional image backup immediately prior to installing a Windows update. That's a safety net because you know that you're doing it for that update. If the update fails, you've got your safety net. If the update succeeds, you no longer need the safety net. The second type are regular backups. These are the kinds that you are taking automatically. These are the kinds that we've been talking about up until this point. They are the ones that I strongly recommend you have happen regularly. My recommendation is at least daily, so that no matter what happens, you generally don't lose any more than today's work. And even then, there are other techniques you can apply or layer on top of these backups that will allow you to save things in a little bit more real-time fashion. But the regular backups that we've been talking about, the scheduled backups, these are things that I think everybody needs to have in place. And like I said, are the kinds of things that I've been talking about so far. The third kind that we actually haven't touched on are what I call archives. And archives can be any number of different kinds of things. There are a couple of different approaches to them. One is you might just say, you know what, this collection of files over here, I'm going to copy them somewhere else and never get rid of them. That's an archive, right? That's something you'll want to refer to forever, as far as you can think of. Another approach to archiving, and something that I've been known to do, is I will save my daily backups for a month, my monthly backups for a quarter, my quarterly backups for a year, and then my yearly backups get saved forever. My yearly backups then become kind of an archive of everything that happened to be going on, in this case, in my case, on the 1st of January of every year. It's a snapshot, a point in time, that allows me to refer back should I need to. And yes, while I say that I keep them quote unquote forever, I don't. Some years from now, when I'm cleaning up disk space, I'll say, oh man, that backup from that old machine that I don't have anymore, I'm just never going to use that. I can save space and delete it now. On the other hand, I absolutely have those kind of backups from machines that I haven't used for 15 or 20 years, simply because They're 20 year old. I don't know what kind of gold is in those machines. So I'm saving those as my archive. Those are the kinds of things that you can think about when you're thinking about how long you want to keep, not just your ongoing backups, but your data in general. What do you want to archive? How long do you want to keep it? What is the kind of stuff that you think is important enough or could potentially be important enough to save for much longer than just a few months? So how long should you keep backups? Well, like I said, there is just no general rule that I would apply that would make sense for everybody. I gave you my, you know, if you don't want to think about it early on in this video, daily backups, keep them for 3 months is what it boils down to. But it's important to understand, like, the first few days are critical. That's come across several times in what I've said so far. Things that happen quickly can then be recovered from quickly. How long you need to keep them after that is a function of, well, how confident are you that you'll discover something that you need from a backup someday that might need to go back a certain amount of distance in time? What would be the cost to, instead of being able to recover it from a backup, recreate it? In some cases, like installed programs is a good one, sometimes it's actually cheaper in terms of time and energy spent to just repurchase the program than it is to, like, recover a key or a program file or whatever from an old backup that you no longer have. That's, again, that's a sliding scale, a decision that only you can make. Is there any reason, on the other side of the coin, is there any reason that you can't just throw more disk space at the problem and keep saving backups? Honestly, disk space is cheap. Backups that lie around and do nothing don't really cost you anything other than disk space. So that's another approach that you might want to consider. Yeah, and if you end up keeping 3 years worth of backups, 3 years from now, if you suddenly are running out of disk space, you've got more options, right? You may decide that, yep, all those backups from 3 years ago, I don't need them anymore. But exactly what the window is, be it 3 months or 3 years, is not something I can judge. But hopefully, you'll now have some ideas on exactly what to think about when you answer this question for your own specific situation. I hope that was helpful. For updates, for related links, for comments and more, visit askleo.com/23473. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.